me this morning, Steve Promnitz from QX Resources. Steve, good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for the opportunity.
Look, Steve, you and I have spoken a number of times previously. What led you to join QXR?
So QX Resources, as you've said, ticker code QXR on the ASX, they're a good solid platform in the battery mineral space, and they also have some nice gold assets. I've been looking for a while for something that I was able to leverage some of my skills from working in the lithium space. QXR has a good portfolio of assets, particularly on the hard rock side for hard rock lithium in Western Australia. One of their projects is 15 kilometres from one of the best known projects in WA, Wodgina, and these things tend to cluster around. And there's an opportunity perhaps to add to that as time goes by, but it's a very good base. They also have some gold assets, and despite the fact that the macro for battery minerals looks solid, it's always good to have a nice little patch of gold properties. Next, they're quite well funded, $4 million in the bank, and I suspect that the equity markets for junior companies could look a bit rocky over the next 18 months. And on top of that, they've got a board where each of the board members have got different skill sets that work together. So it's a good little platform. It is quite small. It's only about a 65 million market value, but I think a great base to then build the next key player in this battery mineral space.
Well, give us a bit more detail, Steve, as far as what your plans are, what you're looking to do at QXR.
So as I mentioned, there's a couple of projects I particularly like in Western Australia. One's called Turner River. The other one is called Split Rock. And Split Rock is a new setting for pegmatites, whereas Turner River is a sort of a repeat lookalike without them sticking out of the ground for Wodgina or Pilkangoora. But of course, we have to go and drill that, and I'm actually trying to organise the timing of a drill program at the moment. Rigs are becoming more available in Western Australia, but also I'm concerned about the rains coming into WA like we've seen on the East Coast. So we're just trying to work out the timing. We'd also like to get some drilling done on our gold projects in Queensland. But again, it's just been raining cats and dogs in Eastern Australia. So that could affect that. So that's sort of on the work plan. And I'll be releasing more information about surface results and our work plans, and so people can see what's happening there. But really the main game is that the size of demand for battery minerals is really quite spectacular. And I don't think the forecasters have it right. Everybody has demand dipping off or pricing dipping off. I can't see that at all. Europe, US, China, even if we move into recession, the demand there is legislated. And so a way to concertina that timeline and actually deliver material into that demand now is to bring those end users, cathode makers, battery makers, car makers, financiers involved in the exploration development phase. That way you're not diluting your shareholders as much. You're getting them involved because they need these projects and they need them now. So that's essentially what we're trying to do at QX Resources.
So Steve, near term, what's your news flow looking like?
So near term, we'll get some surface results out about our lithium projects probably at the end of October. Labs are backed up, but that's roughly the timeline. It might dribble into the start of November. As I mentioned, I hope to announce the next couple of weeks exactly when we will be able to drill. I would like to be able to drill some of these projects together with geophysics in WA at the latter part of this calendar year. That's certainly our aim, and the same in Queensland, but that may end up being the end of the first quarter next year. And at the same time, you could expect some more news about some of the partners that we're working with. And I still have a few surprises up my sleeve. So I think if you watch this, I can't guarantee it's going to perform like my last shop, but I think it's going to do quite well. Thanks so much.
Good to speak this morning, Steve. Thank you.